system, Martha. Some scientists now say yes. British and Spanish astronomers say that there may be at least two more planets hiding behind Pluto, which still doesn't count as a planet, by the way. Ripped off. Mike Massimino is a former NASA astronaut and professor of engineering at Columbia University. How are you, sir? What's it matter?
Well, if this would be a major discovery, if we can find that there are, if there actually are more planets in our solar system, it would be a major find. Would it affect our daily life? Maybe not so much, but certainly we have to rewrite a few of the astronomy books.
I got you. So I always thought there were nine planets.
That's what we learned. That's what we learned when we were kids.
I'm told I'm wrong. Now, what's the deal?
Right. When we were kids, it was nine. Then there, you know, there was a controversy a few years ago. They said, no, there's only eight, and now there may be some more out there. So it just goes to show you, we keep finding more and more stuff.
And Pluto's not living up. Now, listen.
Yep.
How do they go about determining there's another planet out there? How do we find that? How do we locate it?
This is what I find to be most interesting. You know, as an astronaut, I got to work on Hubble. But I was like the repairman. I don't look through the telescope, but we talk to these astronomers how they use a device like the Hubble Space Telescope, or how these guys made their discovery. They look for evidence. They find things, and they don't know why they're seeing this evidence. So what they found, there's a bunch of rocks out beyond Pluto, way out there in our solar system, that were being disturbed more or less by gravity. Their pattern was not as it normally would be, naturally occurring, if they were just those objects floating around. So they see something else pulling on them and disturbing the orbit, and they don't know what that is. So the theory that they have is that there's more planets, really big ones, way far away.
So it's based on the solar system. It's possible they have not even seen these planets.
Yeah, I don't think they have. In fact, the only evidence that I'm aware of that I've read about here is that it's a gravitational attraction, and one of the ways that they would explain this is to say that there's other planets out there. It's with the Hubble Space Telescope, dark energy and dark matter, and this is at the Intrepid Museum now. They have the Hubble 25 exhibit, and you see some of the stuff. They talk about things like gravitational lensing, which means they can look on a lens. There's a picture of this in the museum where you can see the bending of light, and so the light can actually bend, and they can measure the bending of light, and they would say, well, what matter is around here that's causing that bend in the light? And then he said, well, there's got to be so much matter, but they can only recognize a portion of the matter.
Or
that's why they come up with dark matter. So there's more stuff out there than we can account for. We can measure gravitation.
Or the possibility that it's emitting light, right? Or it's sending light back, and that's how you would locate it.
Right.
So it would reflect the light of the sun.
Yeah, but they don't know what this stuff is. So they call it dark matter, for example. In this case, what their hunch is that it's a planet that's out there that's causing this gravitational
difference. You going to be okay with this?
Yeah, I think this is cool. I think what it shows you is, you know, you think you know something and you don't. We really don't know what's going on. You know, dark matter, dark energy, we only can recognize like 10% of the energy in the universe, 10% of them. We don't know what the heck is going on out there. Very exciting stuff.
And quickly, when you were growing up, you memorized the planets in a very peculiar way. And what was that again?
It was my very educated mother just served us nine pizza pies.
She did.
And each one of those words, that gives you, you start with Mercury, Venus, or right there. We're going to have to update that. We got to come up with names, too.
I don't know
what they're going to do. So
to make more pizza.
Something. All right,
thank you, Mike.
Thanks for having me.
See you soon.
Right.
Okay.
Team. I don't know if you guys have heard about this yet, but there is a mysterious object. Scientists don't know what it is, but that it's coming from out in interstellar space. And it's the first, I guess you could say, interstellar visitor that astronomers have ever detected. As in, the first object that is actually coming out there from outside the solar system in interstellar space, coming in and then exiting. And that's exactly what it's doing. And so this mystery object, which they originally thought was a comet, but it turned out that it wasn't, and we'll get more to that here in a minute, is called A2017U1. And it was discovered earlier this month by a researcher using a sophisticated telescope system at the University of Hawaii that continually scans the universe for such phenomenon. And so what they originally thought may have been a small asteroid or comet that they spotted racing through our solar system may have come from elsewhere in the galaxy. And U.S. space scientists say that it's possibly the first ever interstellar visitor observed from Earth. They have now confirmed what at some points they're calling a chunk of ice, other times an asteroid, and other times saying they don't know, from this Hawaiian telescope back on October 19th. And it's already passed by and headed back out away from planet Earth. And while scientists say that they can study it for a few more weeks, they said that once it waves goodbye, we'll never see it again. And so here's some weird things about this object. And scientists are coming out and making no, you know, joke about it. They're not trying to hide the fact it's a strange object. And that's why they're so excited about it to begin with. So it was first dubbed a comet. However, they discovered that the object doesn't contain any hallmarks of one of the main components of a comet, which is the trademark tail, or coma, which is this fuzzy blob of gas and dust that surrounds a comet's icy core. So as they kept observing this thing, and astronomers kept looking at it, they didn't spot any tail. So that's when it went from comet to possible asteroid to we don't know. I mean, honestly, for all we know, it could be some sort of probe or alien spacecraft. And that's just as good a theory as what the astronomers are putting forth. And what's also strange about the object is that this just doesn't happen, all right? We have many objects in our solar system and even outside of the solar system that come in and out. We have names for most of them. They orbit the sun, they orbit Earth, they fly in, they fly out. And all of these objects, from asteroids or comets, they come from two main regions out in space. First is the Kuiper Belt, which circles the cosmic block around Neptune, Pluto, and beond. Then we have the Oort Cloud, which is a bubble of ice particles that surrounds the entire solar system at such great distances that we've never even seen it. Now, just to put this into context, the New Horizons mission that flew past Pluto is currently on its way to visit a Kuiper Belt object on January 1st of 2019, whereas the Voyager missions that launched 40 years ago won't actually escape the Oort Cloud for at least another 14,000 years. But no matter where these other objects in our solar system come from, none of them have ever had a path like this new anomalous object. Paul Chodas, the manager at NASA's Center for Near-Earth Object Studies, said that we've been waiting for this day for decades, and it's been long theorized that such objects exist, as in objects that are moving around between the stars and occasionally passing through our solar system. And this is the very first detection. So this object, whatever it is, it could have came from the other side of the galaxy. And some people are saying that it very well could be a drone, an alien drone of some sort. You know, we have long spoken about the theory that's been put forth by numerous astrophysicists and theoretical physicists that if an advanced alien species exists, likely, when they're scouring and visiting different parts of the galaxy, instead of sending themselves, they would instead send out these robotic drones, or droids. Many people talk about the small alien grays as a manifestation of some of these droids, which although are basically robots that, you know, are flying out here in these UFOs, are intelligent and are beaming back information to the actual alien beings in other parts of the galaxy. And that may be why so many of the abduction cases and testimony from people have described these alien grays as almost soulless and having a very robotic nature to them. And so back to this object here. They know that it's about 400 meters in diameter, or a quarter mile. And it stood out for the scientists because of its extreme orbit, coming from the direction of the constellation Lyra, almost directly above the elliptical plane where the planets and other asteroids orbit the sun. NASA said, quote, "It's going extremely fast and on such a trajectory that we can say with confidence that this object is on its way out of the solar system and is not coming back. Now, obviously, NASA and these astronomers who are under lock and key would not give us any real information about this object. And so you kind of have to read these reports and kind of look for any inconsistencies or strange things. And one thing that I noticed in all of these reports is that there's a single mention of the fact that astronomers have had some trouble tracking this object. And they don't go into further detail, but that tells me that this object, it's not like your typical asteroid or comet where you can track it all the way in, you track it all the way out. That at least tells me that there could be possibly some movement by this object that the astronomers did not expect. And it's causing them to have trouble to track this thing, whatever it is. And I'll leave that there. You guys tell me what you think. You know, I wouldn't doubt it. It could definitely be something artificial. Now, in other news, is this enormous glowing orb or ball that was spotted over northern Siberia, which originally literally led people to fear there was an alien invasion happening. No joke. And so people living in northern Siberia had been left terrified after this enormous white ball of light appeared in the sky, hung around for a while, and then disappeared. This light show was captured by a photographer named Sergei Anisimov, who was in the town of Salekhard, which borders the Arctic Circle. He described what he witnessed as a glowing ball rising from behind the forest and moving in his direction. And you're seeing these photos here in order as the object appeared, hung out for a while, and then dissipated. And you're seeing the aurora borealis in the background, or the northern lights as they're called. So at first he said that he was taken aback. He didn't know what he was looking at. He suspected at first that he was being tracked by an incredibly powerful searchlight. However, the speed of the ball and the change in its light quickly made him realize that he was witnessing something very different, stating that the ball turned into an arc and gradually dissipated. Anisimov headed home, where he said he found local children as young as 5 in a very excited state talking about aliens and a portal to another dimension. Reports suggest that it wasn't only children who thought the Earth was about to be invaded. Adults also took to social media to claim that aliens were here and attributed the light show to a UFO. Now, the source of the light is still unclear at this point. It's been suggested that the ball was caused by the trace of a rocket which was launched, although we don't have any definitive proof, but nonetheless, it spooked the locals. And so I wanted to post it here. It's good to document these things. We can go back, we can compare other photographs. And yeah, you guys tell me what you think. So with that, I want to thank you guys for stopping by. I hope all of you or some of you went over and watched the